I was brought here of complaining of just leg pain. And we just massage it with warm water, cold water. And after that, we put the shea butter, and then we bandage it.
What was the state of the, you know, sprain? Because that's what we understand, that it was a sprain.
We saw the condition that we cannot put any hot medicine. That's why you only put the shea butter on it, and then we bandage it.
So was this a shea butter? That
yes, please, yeah.
So my senior colleague just called me, draw my attention on the boy. So we look at it and we meet together and we say, no, this problem, when we apply something hot, it's going to cause us, because the leg is looking shiny, the leg, yeah. So we just apply, we use ordinary water to clean the leg.
Was it swollen?
It was swollen. So we just use.
Did you see any cut?
No, there is no cut. Okay. Actually, there's no cut. So we use.
What was the extent of the swell on the leg? Are you able to tell us? Was it very big?
It's normal. It's not too big. It was normal. So we just use ordinary water to clean the leg. Then we use ordinary shea butter. Nothing. There is nothing inside. You know, shea butter can cure. So we use ordinary shea butter on the leg.
This latest injury that we're talking about, how many days did you come, you know, into contact with him, the patient?
Once. He came here once and he didn't come again.
In the information making around on social media, that the boy actually came here and you gave him a lot of concoctions.
We say no, and we want to ask the public and the general world that, can shea butter let somebody breathe from the ear and from the mouth? I want the public to judge. Can ordinary shea butter applied on the leg can cause that? The world should judge.